Hey guys, welcome back to Cam's Corner. I'm your host, as always, Camden Revere. Very excited to be here today to talk to you about something very, very underrated in the game of court tennis, and that is serving. Now, because we get two serves, and serving is relatively easy, just having to hit the ball onto the side penthouse here, most people tend to take it for granted and not focus very much. And one of the most underrated serves within this is the bobble. Now, many of you are going to know the bobble. It's the one of the first serves we teach you. It's generally the second serve. So after you've missed your first serve, this is your safety net. But the bobble can actually be one of the most effective serves in all of court tennis, because what we're trying to accomplish with it actually stops your opponent from doing just about anything they can with the ball. So now, a bobble is a serve that we hit from last gallery in the middle of the court, and the objective is to get that ball to roll up the penthouse as high as we can so it almost hits the side wall and creates a very severe angle coming down the court, dropping flush with that back wall and dying. Now, what this does is it accomplishes a few things. First of all, when hit well, it stops your opponent from volleying the return of serve. So for any of your opponents that come from a lawn tennis background or just generally like to volley, it stops them from being able to do that. And at the same time, for anybody who likes to force that ball off the back wall and hit it nice and hard, because that ball is dying into that corner, it makes it very hard for them to generate pace or hit the ball hard accurately. So when done right, the bobble is actually one of the most effective serves in all of court tennis. It stops your opponent regardless of what they favor doing, and it also puts you on offense. One of the most important parts of the bobble, though, is that it's a dead weight ball. And what I mean by that is, by the time that ball is dying in the back wall and leaving the penthouse, there's no momentum on that ball, forwards or backwards. It's just a dead ball sitting there, which means that all of the power, the control, the spin on that ball is going to come from your opponent. And that is one of the hardest things to do in court tennis, is to control that ball from that perspective. We want that ball coming at us with pace or coming off the wall with pace so that we can use that to our advantage, so that we don't have to do it all ourselves. It's very hard to control the spin, your depth, your control of length on your shot when you have to do it all yourself. Okay, so what we're going to do today is we're going to teach you how to hit a good bobble. Okay, so doesn't matter if you're left-handed or right-handed, you're going to stand at the exact same spot. Okay, we want you at last gallery in the dead center of the court. Now, the reason we put you here is not because it's the best angle, because the best angle would in fact be closer to the side wall, but it's because it's the safest angle that we can get and still get back to our ready position at the middle of the court and the back of the court after we serve, right? So we want to be able to hit the most effective serve we can, but also make sure that we get back into position before our opponents have time to hit the ball. Okay, so we stand at last gallery in the middle. All right, we're gonna hit that ball nice and soft up. We're looking for our first bounce to hit somewhere around hazard first gallery, going up the penthouse, bouncing multiple times, almost getting to the top of the penthouse to the side wall. And really, that's where we want the ball to die, okay? We want gravity to then take that ball the rest of the way down into the bucket, okay? And what I mean by that is, think of it in golf terms if you play golf, but we basically wanna putt this ball up to the side wall. Okay, we want to have it hit over hazard first gallery, and we want it to roll up to the sidewall, and we want it to stop there. That's the end of our work. And then gravity will naturally take the ball the rest of the way through its arc. Okay, so we're doing half of the arc, and then gravity is doing the rest of the arc. The higher up the penthouse we get, the better of an angle that we're going to get coming down the penthouse. And that's what's going to create a tighter ball on that back wall. Okay, now you'll see that there's a bucket down there at the other end of the court. All right, that is my objective today, and this is a drill you can do on your own too. It's to come out here, grab a few balls, and try and hit bobbles that go up and have nice severe angles coming down and land in that bucket. Okay, so I'm gonna give you a few examples now. See how you go.